गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम,
यस मैम,
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग। रोल नंबर वन,
यस मैम,
टू,
प्रेजेंट मैम,
थ्री,
प्रेजेंट मैम,
फोर,
प्रेजेंट मैम,
फाइव,
यस मैम,
सिक्स,
प्रेजेंट मैम,
सेवन,
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ओके, शोभन प्रेजेंट।
मैम रोल नंबर 21 प्रेजेंट।
रोल नंबर 18 एंड रोल नंबर 21।
मैम 18 प्रेजेंट।
21 प्रेजेंट।
रोल नंबर 18, हु इज रोल नंबर 18?
मैम रोहित मुखर्जी।
एंड रोल नंबर 21?
मैम सौरभ कुमार प्रेजेंट।
ओके, सो ऑल आर प्रेजेंट। Now the sharing screen is visible or not?
Visible, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Any rectangular shape are you getting there in red?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am.
Actually, what is happening, I don't know in flashback whenever I record, but when I was recording today, that the problem arose. That is, the problem is that this line is coming here. I don't know when I will record. The remaining portion will not be recorded, only this portion will be recorded. How it is created, I don't know, but you can see the whole. whole page?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but something problem in recording, I think. So I have to adjust later. Magnetic, yesterday I discussed about magnetic permeability, then permeability of free space, permeability of medium, relative permeability, then different magnetic materials, diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic materials, the relation between relative permeability and magnetic susceptibility. This is the relation chi m equal to mu r minus 1, that was also proved. So remember this one, this is very important. Then flux density, and from flux density, BH loop or magnetic hysteresis loop, that I also discussed yesterday. And in magnetic hysteresis loop, what is residual magnetism, what is coercive force, that I also discussed. So this is important, what do you mean by residual magnetism or and coercive force. If any MCQ question is given, maybe you get question from this. The options will be given. Residual magnetism is option A, B, C, D, or coercive force is A, B, C, D, like this. So this is the BH curve or magnetic hysteresis loop. This is the important property of ferromagnetic material. So this path is called magnetic hysteresis loop. What is the path? A, B, C, D, E, F, A. So starting from here, A, B, C, D, E, F, A. Starting from one saturation point, it is coming in this direction, then meeting again here. And everything I discussed yesterday, how it is changing. So what is the significance of magnetic hysteresis loop? That was also given in the note. Actually, I have not given the note of 2 days. I will give it today. And there are magnetic hysteresis loops for soft and hard materials. Soft ferromagnetic material, you can see this is small coercive force and this is large coercive force for hard ferromagnetic material. You can see the width is here large and it is small width. So this is actually the coercive force. So this is the coercive force from this point center to C. So if this width is large, so this is the coercive force is large. So this is soft ferromagnetic material and this is hard ferromagnetic material. So here coercive force is small for soft ferromagnetic material and large coercive force is hard ferromagnetic material. This also remember may be given in MCQ. So these are the properties of hard and soft magnetic materials. So soft magnetic materials, they can be easily magnetized, easily demagnetized. So different properties are there, low coercivity, high permeability. So these are the properties. And hard magnetic materials, difficult to magnetize and difficult to demagnetize. So these are the examples, permanent magnets, recording media, hard magnetic materials. An inductor transformer course here, the examples. Now the domain theory. This theory was proposed by Weiss in 1907 and it explains the hysteresis and the properties of ferromagnetic material. So by the domain theory, we can explain the hysteresis and the properties of the ferromagnetic material. So here, different domains are shown in this figure. A ferromagnetic material is divided into a large number of small regions, is called the domains. So this is one, this is domain, this is another, this is another. So these are different domains, and you can see the boundaries. So a ferromagnetic material is divided into a large number of small regions, is called the domains. Each domain is spontaneously magnetized. Each domain is spontaneously magnetized. So each domain is, so this domain, this domain, this domain, they are different domains. So each domain is spontaneously magnetized. The direction of magnetization varies from domain to domain. So the direction you can see, this is the direction, upward direction. And here it is in this direction. Here it is downward direction. So in this way, different directions are shown. The direction of magnetization varies from domain to domain. And the net magnetization is zero in the absence of external magnetic field. Two domains separates by domain wall or block wall. You can see, so this is the domain wall. So two domains are separated by domain wall or block wall. The domains are rotated parallel to the field direction. So these are the points for magnetic domains. Now, explanation of the magnetic domain. A magnetic domain is a region within a magnetic material in which the magnetization is in a uniform direction. This means that the individual magnetic moments of the atoms are aligned with one another and they point in the same direction. When cooled below a temperature called the Curie temperature, the magnetization of a piece of ferromagnetic material spontaneously divides into many small regions called the magnetic domains. The magnetization within each domain points in a uniform direction, but the magnetization of different domains may point in different direction, and that was shown in figure, in that figure. So in that figure, it was shown that magnetization of each domain points in a uniform direction, but the magnetization of different domains may point in different directions. Magnetic domain structure is responsible for the magnetic behavior of ferromagnetic materials. So this domain structure, magnetic domain structure, is responsible for the magnetic behavior of the ferromagnetic material. And what are the ferromagnetic materials? Some examples like iron, nickel, cobalt, some alloys, etc. So these are the materials. So their magnetic domain structure you will get. This includes the formation of permanent magnets and the attraction of ferromagnetic material to a magnetic field. The regions separating the magnetic domains, I already shared, this is called domain wall. So the regions separating the magnetic domains are called the domain walls, where the magnetization rotates coherently from the direction in one medium to that in the next domain. The study of magnetic domains is called the micromagnetics. Magnetic domains form in materials which have magnetic ordering, that is, their dipoles spontaneously align to the exchange interaction. Due to the exchange interaction, they are ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic, etc. Paramagnetic and diamagnetic materials in which the dipoles align in the presence to an external field but do not spontaneously align do not have magnetic domains. So magnetic domains, there are no magnetic domains for paramagnetic and diamagnetic materials. So remember this one, there is no existence of magnetic domain for paramagnetic and diamagnetic material. So just go through it, you will understand this. Why the domains form different theories are there. So here also it is shown that different domains are shown in this figure. So this is the domain wall. Now, eddy current loss. When an alternating magnetic field is applied to a magnetic material, an EMF is induced in the material itself, according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Since the magnetic material is a conducting material, these EMFs circulate current within the body of the material, and these circulating currents are called the eddy currents. So this is the figure for the eddy current, showing the eddy current. These circulating currents are called the eddy currents, and they will occur when the conductor experiences a changing magnetic field. As these currents are not responsible for doing any useful work and it produces a loss, that is I square R, in the magnetic material, it is known as the eddy current loss. So I square R, this is the loss. Similar to hysteresis loss, eddy current loss also increases as the temperature of the also increases with the temperature of the magnetic material. The hysteresis and the eddy current losses in a magnetic material are also known by the name iron losses or core losses or magnetic losses. So this is another name given. So from here, what is important? The definition of eddy current and what is eddy current loss. So there are different points here, just read it. So different points are written here. If the core is made up of solid iron of larger cross-sectional area, the magnitude of the current will be large and hence the loss will be high. To reduce the eddy current loss, mainly there are two methods. So we have to reduce the loss. So there are two methods. First one is by reducing the magnitude of the eddy current. The magnitude of the current can be reduced by splitting the solid core into thin sheets called laminations in the plane parallel to the magnetic field. Each lamination is insulated from the other by a thin layer of coating of varnish or oxide film. By laminating the core, the area of each section is reduced and hence the induced EMF also reduces. As the area through which the current is passed is smaller, the resistance of the eddy current path increases. The eddy current loss is also reduced by using a magnetic material having a higher value of resistivity like silicon steel. So this is another way by which we can reduce eddy current loss. So here shown, that is laminated magnetic core. This is the procedure. We have to laminate by laminating a core. Now application of eddy current, there are different applications. Advanced portable eddy current flaw detectors inspect metallic parts and perform highly reliable flaw detection of surface and near surface defects. Eddy current probes generate magnetic fields that induce current that flows in a test phase, influencing the magnetic field and magnitude and the phase of the voltage of the coil. Applications include the detection of surface or near surface defects, alloy shorting, and the inspection of bolt holes. So these are the applications of eddy current. There are different applications on electromagnetism also. A branch of physics that deals with electric current or fields or magnetic fields and their interaction on substances or matter, that is called the electromagnetism. Electromagnetism has created a great revolution in the field of engineering applications. In addition, this caused a great impact on various fields such as medical, industrial and space, etc. We can find enormous practical application of electromagnetism in everyday life, from domestic appliances to research applications. In domestic applications, we can observe the phenomena of lighting, heating, and kitchen appliances in communication system. This exists in all telecommunication equipments and communication networks. In industrial system, this can be applied in motors, generators, sensors and actuators, devices, etc. Now, electromagnetism serves as a basic principle of working for many of the home appliances. Security system use locking system. So for security system, this is used. Magnetic hard card reader on the doors reads the number of the keys stored in the magnetic tape of the card. So these are different applications here. Industrial applications, almost all of the instruments or devices used in industries are based on electromagnetism. Materials used in constructing such devices include iron, cobalt, nickel, etc., which naturally responds to the magnetic fields. So these are the different applications of magnetism. Starting from small control instruments to the large power equipments, the electromagnetism is used at least at one stage of their working. Various sensors, actuating devices works on electromagnetism. Electromagnetic sensors include Hall effect sensors, magnetoresistive sensors. So these are different applications. Just read it. It is given in detail. Magnetic levitation trains. This is the modern technology of transportation system that use the concept of electromagnetism. These are called as high-speed trains, which use powerful electromagnets to develop the speed. So different applications are here. The shown this is magnetic trains, magnetic levitation trains, that is also shown here, this figure. So in this way, different applications we can see. Next is communication system. It is the process of transmitting information from a source to a receiver. This transmission of energy over long distances is carried out through electromagnetic waves at high frequencies. These waves are also called as microwaves or high frequency radio waves. So this is also the important application of electromagnetism in communication system. If we use mobile phone, then you know that sound energy is converted into electromagnetic energy. Now, by using the radio transmitter, this electromagnetic energy is transferred to the receiver. At the receiver, these electromagnetic waves are again transformed back to the sound energy. So in this way, mobile phone works. So sound energy is converted to electromagnetic energy. Then at the receiver end, this electromagnetic waves again transform back to its sound energy. So in this way, communication system, different applications are there. So just read it. In medical system also used of electromagnetism. Electromagnetic fields may play a key role in advanced medical equipment. So here MRI, you know, magnetic resonance imaging. This is one detecting system. So in medical system for MRI purpose, it is used. Radio frequency range frequencies are mostly used in medical applications. So MRI scan, where we can get the details of our human body. So total human body scan by MRI, it is possible in medical system by the application of electromagnetism. So it is the figure here shown. The electromagnetic therapy is an alternate form of medicine which claims to treat diseases by applying pulsed electromagnetic fields or electromagnetic radiation to the body. This type of treatments is used for wide range of for nervous disorders, diabetes, spinal cord injuries, ulcer, asthma, for many things. Many of the medical equipments such as scanners, x-ray equipments and other equipments uses electromagnetic, the application of electromagnetism. So these are the different examples of using electromagnetism. Now here I end this chapter, that is magnetism or Maxwell equation. I already discussed before that. So for this chapter, from this whole, you will, what type of question you will get? You may get that first starting from Maxwell equation in differential form. What is the significance of the Maxwell equation? Then the Maxwell equation in free space. Write down the Maxwell equation of free space. You may get this type of question. And the wave equation for electric field and also for magnetic field, and that formula that is very, very important, C equal to 1 by root over mu 0 epsilon 0. That is, the electromagnetic wave is transverse in nature. That is also important. So that thing I discussed. And in magnetic materials, the definitions of different type of magnetic materials, diamagnetic material, ferromagnetic material, paramagnetic material, antiferromagnetic materials, everything details I have discussed with examples. Then the hysteresis loop, the magnetic permeability, magnetic susceptibility. In dielectrics, I also discussed these things. That is electric susceptibility. Here I have discussed magnetic susceptibility, permeability, magnetic permeability, susceptibility, their relations. Then today what I have discussed, magnetic domains. What is the magnetic domain? What is domain wall? So magnetic domains is the important property of which type of material? So these are the questions. What is eddy current? Then what is the application of this? What is eddy current loss? And as a whole, the application of magnetism and also electromagnetism in different fields that I have discussed. So this is the end of this module also, module 3. Then I will start, next I am going to start quantum mechanics. From the next day, that is from tomorrow, I will start quantum mechanics. Anyone want to share anything that you are not understanding, you have any problem? I'm not today discussing much more because this chapter is completed, and tomorrow I will start different one, different module. Any problem for anyone, any student want to say anything? And any suggestion? Shruti Kiran?
Yes, ma'am.
So three modules of your, for your syllabus, they are completed. Modules are completed. Are you reading all this previous modules?
Yes, ma'am. I read polarization.
In optics, what are the chapters, say? In optics, what are the chapters included?
Ma'am, polarization, laser. Or dielectrics in module 3.
Module 2 optics. So dielectrics not an optics.
Yes, ma'am.
So polarization, laser, and what are the last one topic?
Polarization.
Shruti, I am saying to Shruti.
Yes, ma'am.
Say polarization, laser, and what is the third one?
Ma'am, gratings.
Grating. Then?
Yes, ma'am.
Diffraction. Third one is diffraction. And in diffraction, everything is there. Grating means end slit. Single slit, you know, I have discussed all these things. Single slit, then double slit, then n number of slits.
Yes, ma'am.
So you are saying only grating. First you said it is dielectrics in your optics. So this is your preparation. Think about it.
Module 3.
Ogneshwar Mukherjee.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So how are you preparing?
I'm not so good, but I'm
why reading. Why not so good? Every note is given.
Yes, ma'am, I am reading the notes thoroughly.
And also I want to know that are you checking the video lectures given? My video lectures, have you checked?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So you have user ID password. You can access that resource.
Okay, ma'am.
Do you know that?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So why you have not tried that thing? Next day inform me. Go with your password,
ma'am.
User ID, just check it. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
My whatever I'm teaching, all the video lectures are given. So you can access the lectures with your user ID and password. Shruti?
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Shruti Kiran, have you checked my video lectures? Any of the video lectures? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
Why? Why no?
Ma'am,
that
actually,
you know,
ma'am, I forget my password.
You forgot your password? Then ask your HOD or coordinator about that you have forgot your password. So you need it. Okay, and tomorrow you will report me.
Okay, ma'am.
Understand? Ognishwar and Shruti, both of you will report me about this tomorrow.
Okay, ma'am.
And I'm also saying to everyone that go through the video lectures, previous video lectures. I have completed 3 modules. Then ask your coordinator to give the password. Understand?
When we have semester exams in March?
In March? What? Which exam?
Semester exam.
I don't know when will be the semester exam. I have no notice. I don't know anything. If
26
I know
Feb, बहुत कोई बोल रहे थे इसीलिए.
कौन बोल रहा था? मुझे कुछ भी नहीं सुनाई दिया. ठीक है. अभी मेरे पास notice भी नहीं है. तो हम
okay.
बता भी नहीं. Fixed. What will be offline, online, or when will be the exam, or that as the classes of first your semester, that is first sem, it is started later, so same time the exam will be there or not, I don't know anything. If I get any news, then I will share. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
2 modules are left. 3 modules I have completed. 2 modules are left, and from tomorrow I will start different module. That is quantum mechanics. I will start tomorrow. Okay. So just what you will do now, all the students, that whatever notes I have given, go through all the notes, all the PPTs, and also you have the password and user ID. Go through the video lectures that is given. And when will be the exam, then you will give the exam. If it is online mode, you will give the exam in online mode. If it is offline, then you will give the exam in offline mode. So you will get the news then. But now what you will do, prepare well for the exam. Prepare yourself. Now I'm leaving the class today early, because from tomorrow I will start different module. Okay. So leaving the class, and definitely today I will share my notes. Yesterday's notes, tomorrow, today's note I will share. Whole magnetic material I will share the notes. There are 3 lecture, total 3 lectures are given. 3 notes, 3 PPTs I will share.